Good morning, Wonder. Let us, today's topic is all pass filters. But before going to that one, let us have a brief look into our continuous time systems. It's a recap from signals and systems course. For example, x of t is my transmitted signal. Let me again stir. This is my transmitted signal. Through some channel or some medium. For example, this can be some your mobile phone. You are trying to speak something and you are transmitting through with the help of electromagnetic signals, and you are trying to receive that at some other mobile phone. Some receiver is there, right? And here the medium corresponds to that free space or air, followed by some optical fiber cables, once again followed by free space. Such medium is there. There's a channel here. Ideally, what we are expecting at the receiver is, this is my received signal. You want to transmit some signal x of t to your receiver, or you want to convey some information to some person with the help of transmitting some signal through free space or through electrical signals medium, with the help of electrical signals. That's what your plan. Ideally, what you are expecting is, ideally, we will expect y of t equals to some constant into x of t minus tau. This is what we are expecting. Have you seen this anywhere? Suppose if you are transmitting some information x of t through some medium or some channel, and you are receiving y of t as the receiver. If you don't want to lose any information, this is what we are going to expect ideally when coming to continuous time case. Y of t should be equals to some constant k. See, constant. Some constant k into x of t minus tau, where tau is a constant delay. Some delay. This is what we are expecting. For example, let us consider you are transmitting some song. It is some song signal. Song. You are transmitting song. Due to this factor, that might be attenuated. For example, let me consider x of t be some song, and y of t equals to 0.9 into x of t minus 2. This is tau, right? 2 seconds. Yeah, what is the meaning of this? Will you lose any information with this? Are you losing any information? Are any distortion is there? Okay, forget about this factor. If I simply gave you y of t equals to x of t minus 2, will you lose any information?
No, sir.
You will listen after 2 seconds, that's it, right? Instead of starting to listen to that song from now onwards, you'll try to listen to that song after 2 seconds. Just do that, right? There is no information loss. It means there is no distortion. There is no distortion at all. Okay, it's fine. Suppose your y of t equals to 0.9 into x of t. Will you lose any information? See, let us consider a scenario where you are listening to a song with the help of your mobile phone. It's something like reducing your volume, right? Is it like reducing volume? It's exactly the same method, right? You are simply reducing the volume of that speaker. You are trying to reduce that volume, right? You won't lose any information, but you will try to listen to that song with some less sound, less intensity. That's what you are observing, right? There won't be any disturbance, or there won't be any distortion, or there no lose of any information. It means these two are okay, right? These two are okay. It is okay. That's fine. Suppose, let me consider some other scenario where My channel gain is as follows. This is my channel gain. Mod H of F. This is frequency versus gain of the channel. It means I am going to get Y of F equals to X of F into H of F. Continuous time case. Let me consider this scenario. Let me consider this corresponds to 4 kilohertz. Yeah, then what happens to this one? Is it 20 kilohertz? I am transmitting my sound through this medium or through this channel with this frequency response. What happens is that will be filtered out, right? Due to these channel effects, low frequencies are having gain of 1, and if you go to high frequency components, they are getting attenuated, right? Then will you get exactly same X of T at the receiver? Will you get same information or different information with this? Are you going to get same information? See, in the earlier case, if I consider 0.9 into X of T, 0.9 into X of T means in frequency domain also that will become like 0.9 into X of F for all F. That means all frequency components are having equal gain after passing through that medium. Equally attenuated, right? All frequency components. But in this case, some frequency components are having gain 1. Some frequency components are having gain of less than 1. It means they got attenuated. Unequal attenuation for different frequency components, right? Then what happens to your X of T? Are you going to get exactly same X of T or something different?
Something different.
Yeah, definitely that will be different. You won't get the signal like attenuated version of your X of T. You'll get some distorted signal because you are disturbing the composition, right? Overall composition of those frequency components. This is known as magnitude dispersion. If the gain is a function of frequency, if the gain is a function of frequency, then you can call it as magnitude dispersion. You won't receive your actual X of T. It is known as magnitude dispersion. Okay, for example, frequency component. Okay, frequency components up to this band of frequencies delayed by tau 1. And the frequency components up to this remaining band delayed by tau 2. Then will you get any disturbance? Unequal delays. Instead of same delay for all frequency components, we are trying to provide unequal delays. Tau 1 delay for, let me consider tau 1 equals to 1 second and tau 2 equals to some 10 seconds. Will it cause any disturbance to you? See, for example, if you consider a song which is having speech component plus music component, right? Let me consider you have music components above 4 kHz just for simplicity and voice components only up to 4 kHz. Now if you are transmitting both signals, that voice plus music combination, through that channel at the same time, but while receiving, if you try to receive that voice component after 1 second and if you try to receive music component after 10 seconds, will it cause any disturbance to you? Is it okay or any issue with this? This is an issue, right? Song means you'll try to play that voice plus music together, right? Due to this unequal delay introduced by your channel, the problem you are going to get in this particular hypothetical example is you are listening to that speech signals first, after that you are listening to music. You are not listening both together, right? That's the issue you are going to get. It means this is known as delay dispersion or phase dispersion. If you have unequal delays for different frequency components, unequal delays for different frequency components implies delay dispersion. You won't get something similar to your exact XRP. You'll get some dispersion version of that one, delay dispersion, right? This is also known as phase dispersion. If unequal gains for different frequency components, then that is known as magnitude dispersion. If all the frequency components are having same gain while passing through that medium or that channel, then there won't be any magnitude dispersion. If all the frequency components in your signal are facing equal amount of delay after passing through that medium, then there won't be any delay dispersion or there won't be any phase dispersion. It's a basic definition that we need to remember. Now you can have a look into this one, right? Suppose if you transmit x of t and you receive some constant k into x of t minus tau at the receiver, it means all frequency components are delayed by same amount tau. Irrespective of frequency component, you are simply replacing t with t minus tau, right? All frequency components are facing equal delay. It means there won't be any delay dispersion. And all frequency components are facing same gain k. It means there won't be any magnitude dispersion. That's what we are expecting, right, from our channel. That should not disturb our signal. Now, if I try to apply Fourier transform for this one, what is the Fourier transform for this? Let me consider x of t Fourier transform is x of f, continuous time Fourier transform. And y of t Fourier transform is y of f. Now, can someone tell me what is the Fourier transform for this? Yeah, you can apply properties of Fourier transform. K into?
X of f into? E power
yes, minus j 2 pi f tau, right? Now, my h of f, channel frequency response will be, is h of f into x of f, right? E power minus j 2 pi f tau, where k is some, let me consider k is greater than 0 and some constant. Is a constant gain. Like that you can think. Then what is my phase? What is the phase introduced by my channel? H of f equals to? What is the phase? See, if I have r e power j theta, r corresponds to magnitude, where if r greater than 0, and theta corresponds to phase, right? Here phase corresponds to minus 2 pi f into tau. This can be written like minus 2 pi tau into f. This is my phase. Is it a linear phase with respect to f or non-linear? Is it a linear phase or non-linear phase? Let me try to plot this, right? Frequency versus phase introduced by channel. Let me consider this is 0. Now what's happening here? Is some negative, right? Minus 2 pi tau. Minus 2 pi, but this is a constant term. This is some constant term minus k. Like that you can think, right? Or for example, minus k dash, for example. I already used k somewhere here, right? Then what happens to this one is, it's a linear, right? This is just minus k dash f. Minus k dash f. Angle h of f equals to minus k dash f. This is linearly changing, right? It's linearly varying. This is my phase. Equals to minus k dash into f. It's linearly varying. It's a linear phase system. Implies linear phase system. Y of t equals to k into x of t minus tau implies linear phase system, right? The system is ideal relay system with some gain is a linear phase system. It's a linear phase system. Now, can I conclude this? If my system is linear phase, then there won't be delay dispersion. Is it true or false? Yeah, can you speak?
True, sir.
It's true, right? Or no phase dispersion. It means when my system is trying to provide linear phase, introduce some linear phase, then that won't provide any delay dispersion, or that won't lead to any phase dispersion. It means ideally we are expecting our channel to provide equal gain for all frequency components and linear phase. That should try to provide linear phase, right? That's what our goal. We need to maintain some constant gain for all frequency components. It should be equal for all frequency components. And that should provide equal delay for all frequency components. Indirectly, you can say that should be linear phase system. Then you can avoid magnitude dispersion with this, and you can avoid phase dispersion with the help of this one. That's what our plan. Okay, I'll try to ask you something. Let me consider this is my x of t and this is my h of e positive omega. In frequency domain, I'm writing. That's Fourier transform for that. Finally, I want some k into x of t minus tau of this form I require at the receiver. It's a linear phase system, right? A linear phase system. Let me consider this one as some constant k into constant. It means there is no magnitude dispersion. Minus j omega, my j omega, let me call it as tau 1. My j omega tau 1 plus theta of omega, where okay, let me go back to that analog a continuous, right? See 2 pi f tau 1 non-linear with respect to f. For example, theta of f, for example, theta of f equals to f square. For example, theta of f equals to f square. Or theta of f equals to tan inverse f by 2. This is also non-linear, right? Something like that. This is my theta f. This is some non-linear with respect to frequency f. Non-linear functions. It's a linear function, right? It's a linear with respect to f. But this part is non-linear. Now, can someone guide me? What will be this response? What will be this inverse system response? This is my channel response. I received some disturbance, right? Due to this nonlinear phase, at my receiver. This is my receiver. What's happening is, due to this nonlinear phase, I am getting phase dispersion or delay dispersion. I want to remove this nonlinearity in the phase. Then what should be my hi of e equals j omega? Is it okay if my hi of e equals j omega is like this? J 2 pi f tau 2. This is also linear phase. There is no issue in that. Minus theta of f. Is it true or false? Is it okay? These two will be multiplied, right? If I maintain some system at my receiver like this, this is my system at my receiver. I want to equalize this channel effects. I want to remove this part. For that, I have designed a system with this property. HIF equals j omega equals to e power minus j 2 pi f tau 2 minus theta. These two gets multiplied, right? Because these two are LTA systems. The overall impulse response will be multiplication of both. Overall transfer function of the system will be multiplication of this one and this one. If I multiply this one with this one, then yeah, what is this after multiplication? K into e power minus j into 2 pi f into tau 1 plus tau 2, right? Is it tau 1 plus tau 2? This is after multiplication. This part I am going to give. This will be cancelled out, right? This part will be cancelled out if you multiply this and this. And I can call this like tau. This is what I am expecting, right? At my receiver. It's a linear phase system. Now, how you compensated the nonlinear phase effects of your channel? With the help of linear phase system or with the help of nonlinear phase system? Is it a linear phase system or nonlinear phase system? This one. This whole thing. Is it linear phase or nonlinear phase? Can you speak? Okay, is it a linear phase system or nonlinear phase system? This one. This is nonlinear phase system, right? Because of this factor, this is nonlinear phase system. We try to compensate the delay dispersion with the help of nonlinear phase system. Some nonlinear phase system. That's what we are doing here, right? Generally, we will try to get the help from all pass filters. We already have all pass filters at this location. With the help of all pass filters, where the all pass filter contains some nonlinear phase in that one, we'll try to get help from such all pass filters and we'll try to compensate this phase effects, nonlinear phase effects. That's what we are going to do. For that purpose, we require all pass filters. Yeah, let us have a look into all pass systems or all pass filters. H all pass of Z equals to Z power minus 1 minus A star divided by 1 minus A Z power minus 1. And then where we are having pole? Pole at what point? What is the pole of this? Z equal to A, right? If you equate this denominator to 0, then we are going to get pole at Z equal to A. Pole at Z equal to A. And where we are having 0? 0 at, if you equate this one to 0, Z power minus 1 minus A star equal to 0 implies Z equals to 1 by A star, right? Z equals to 1 by A star. We are having 0 at A star, 1 by A star. Where A star is complex conjugate of this A. This A can be complex number also. This can be complex or this can be real number, this A. If this is real, A star will be same as A. If this is real, A star is nothing but A, right? Okay, if you want stable system, stable and causal, what should be my ROC here? Yeah, what should be the properties? Which one is correct? I'll try to write two things. Yeah, which one is true? I want to have this one like a stable and causal system. Stable and causal system. Then what should be my ROC? This first one or second one? Which one?
First one, sir.
First one, right? This is my ROC. For causality, I need to maintain this one. And for stability, mod Z equal to 1 should be part of my ROC. If mod A less than 1, mod Z equal to 1 will be part of my ROC. And that will become like stable and causal system, right? The stable and causal system. This is an all pass system. All pass system means gain should be 1. This is my claim. For all omega, mod h of e by j omega equal to 1. I am claiming that this is an all pass system. Let us try to prove this. I simply replace z with e power j omega. Then this is equals to z power minus 1 minus a star, right? E power minus j omega minus a star divided by 1 minus e power minus j omega into a, right? 1 minus a z power minus 1. Now if I try to take this part common, e power minus j omega, in the denominator, numerator part, then I am going to get 1 minus a star e power j omega divided by 1 minus a e power minus j omega. Okay, I'll try to do some manipulation here. This is equals to a e power minus j omega whole star. Is it true or false? This part.
True, sir.
Right. There is no issue with this, right? This can be written like this one. Now, if I take magnitude of this one, if I take magnitude of this mod h alpha of e power j omega, then what happens is this is the magnitude of this one. Mod AB equals to mod A into mod B. Then magnitude of this is 1. Mod E power minus J omega is 1. And magnitude of this one also 1. Magnitude of this one also 1. Because of this reason. If you are having something like this, X minus JY divided by X plus JY. What is the magnitude of this? It's 1, right? This is just a complex conjugate of this one. If you want, you can see this one. This entire thing is a complex conjugate of this one. The complex conjugate of this denominator is same as this one. Because 1 star is 1, right? And if I take magnitude of this one, that's equals to 1. See, for all omega, right? Irrespective of omega, the gain of this alpha filter is 1. That's the reason we are calling it as alpha system. See, low pass filter means, according to our digital terminology, that should try to allow frequencies like this, right? Let me understand, this is ideal low pass filter. Pi is the highest possible frequency, 0 is the lowest possible frequency in digital case. This is my low pass filter. Because that's trying to allow only low frequency components. It's trying to reject high frequency components. And high pass filter corresponds to, they'll try to allow high frequency components and they'll try to reject low frequency components, right? This is my high pass filter. It's allowing frequencies nearby this pi, rejecting frequencies nearby zero, right? This is known as high pass filter. All pass filter means that will try to allow all frequencies. It's providing equal gain for all frequencies. See my pi and this is pi. This is known as all-pass filter. All-pass filter. It will try to provide equal gain for all frequencies. That's why you know it's known as all-pass filter. This need not be 1. This can be some constant k, which is not equal to 0. That's also fine. Still, you can call it as all-pass filter. K not equal to 0. It's a magnitude response. Whatever I have plotted is just magnitude response of that one. It's an all-pass, low pass and high pass. It means this system corresponds to all pass system. This is an all pass system. Okay, is it a linear phase system or non-linear phase system? Let me rewrite this once again. Chapi power j omega equals to z power minus 1 minus a star, right? A star divided by 1 minus a z power minus 1, z with e power j omega, right? Let me consider a complex number, right? If I consider a to be complex, r e power j theta, this equals to r e power j theta, then my a star will be r e power minus j theta. It's a complex conjugate of this, right? Now if I try to take this part common, e power minus j omega common in this one, then I am going to get 1 minus e power j omega into A star means R e power minus j theta, right? R e power minus j theta divided by 1 minus A means R e power j theta into e power minus j omega. Now this can be written like e power minus j omega into 1 minus r into e power j into omega minus theta divided by 1 minus r into e power minus j into omega minus theta. Like this, I can simplify, right? Up to this. Now I'll try to expand this one. E power j theta means cos theta plus j sin theta, right? That's what I want to apply here. E power minus j omega. This is my h of e power j omega. All pass, right? But take this part common. Then I'm going to get. I'll try to expand this one. Cos omega minus theta plus j sin omega minus theta. And after that, I'll separate real part and imaginary part. 1 minus r cos omega minus theta minus j sin omega minus theta, right? Sin omega minus theta divided by, so it will become like 1 minus r. What is cos r minus theta? Cos r minus theta is cos theta, right?
Of theta is
Yeah, 1 minus r cos omega minus theta is same as this, right? 1 minus r cos omega minus theta and minus of minus, that will be plus, plus j sin omega minus theta. J sin omega minus theta. I already proved that magnitude of this one is 1. No need to worry about magnitude now. Let me look into phase. What the phase of this mod alpha of e power j omega? What is the phase? Before that, let us have a look into this. What is the phase of this?
Tan inverse of y by j.
Tan inverse y by x, right? Tan inverse y by x. This is the phase of this. Then what is the phase of this? X minus j y. Tan inverse minus y by x. Or minus tan inverse y by x. You got tan of minus theta equals to minus tan theta. Minus tan inverse y by x, right? Yeah. This is the phase. The phase of this will be minus omega plus. Okay, what is the phase of this? This is my real part. This is like x minus jy. X minus jy, right? Consider this like x, consider this like y. It means minus tan inverse sin omega minus theta divided by 1 minus r cos into omega minus theta. Then what about the phase of this denominator? The phase of this will be tan inverse sin omega minus theta divided by 1 minus r cos omega minus theta. And then what about 1 by e power j theta? Okay. Yeah, I'll try to write these ones. E power j theta 1 into e power j theta 2 divided by e power j theta 3. Then what is my overall theta? Overall phase.
Theta 1 plus theta 2 minus theta 3.
Yes, theta 1 plus theta 2 minus theta 3, right? Because this gets added, this will be subtracted. Now the same thing I am doing here. This phase is minus omega, and this phase is minus tan inverse of this one, and this phase will be tan inverse of the same thing. And when you get that two numerator, that will become minus. It means 2, right? This is my phase. The phase I am going to get. Is it a linear phase or non-linear phase? With respect to omega, is it linear phase or nonlinear phase? Up to this, there is no issue. This is linear phase. What about this part? Is it linear with respect to omega? It's nonlinear, right? Nonlinear. It's a nonlinear phase system. It's a nonlinear phase system, right? See, the gain of this one is one for all frequencies. But the phase is trying to introduce some phase dispersion, right? But there is a benefit of this. What is the benefit we are going to get? We discussed already, right? This is a benefit we are going to get. Suppose my channel is introducing some phase dispersion, some nonlinear phase. I'll try to give counter for this one. At the receiver, I'll try to design an all-pass filter. All-pass filter, for example, with the gain of one for all frequency components, omega. But with the phase, nonlinear phase, just opposite to this. This is plus, right? This will be minus theta. This is nonlinear phase. This is also nonlinear phase. I'll try to compensate this effect, right? I'll try to cancel this one. Here I'll try to use all-pass system. I'll try to go for all-pass system there. That's what I am going to plan. If my channel is trying to provide some nonlinear dispersion, nonlinear phase dispersion, with plus 2 into tan inverse something like that, then I can try to apply this one, right? This will get cancelled with that one. That's what my plan. If I want, I can try to tune this R and I can tune this theta. There are two tuning parameters for me. Why I am calling it like a tuning parameter means, for example, if my channel is trying to provide if my channel is trying to provide something like this, minus omega, minus 2 omega, for example, linear with respect to omega, and some nonlinear component. It's a nonlinear phase. With respect to omega, some nonlinear component. Now, my target at the receiver is to design all-pass filter with H all-pass of e power j omega equals to, for example, this is just an example, minus omega, minus theta of omega. Is it okay? Any issue with this? If I design like this one, the U2 will be added, right? The U2 pages will be added, and finally I'm going to end up with minus 3 omega, and theta omega gets cancelled out. I want to remove this nonlinear phase effect, right? That's what my plan. This phase gets cancelled out. That's what my target. It means I should try to match this phase with this one, with minus theta of omega. I have to plan in such a manner that this will be equals to minus theta of omega, the nonlinear phase. This theta is different from the theta, or you can say pi of omega, where pi of omega is a nonlinear phase. I'll have to match this one to this minus pi of omega. For that, I can try to change my R, or I can try to change my theta. These are the two parameters where I can tune so that this will be matched to that pi of omega. I'll try to cancel that effect, right? That's what I'm going to plan with the help of all-pass filters.